What's going on? Back again. In today's episode, I'll be sharing with you guys the topic of weighted pull-ups and weighted dips. You guys know that recently I posted a video on weighted pull-ups, and I was talking about why I personally prefer the straight leg variations or the variations with the knees above the hips. That's if you have like a doorway pull-up station. But overall, those are the variations I like a lot because they keep it more of a tucked and more of a stacked position when you're doing these exercises. It's a lot harder to cheat and use a lot of erectors and flare your ribs and hyperextend your neck. It just keeps you in a more aligned position. So it's a lot easier on recovery, and also trains your abs in a fashion that would kind of substitute doing like a hanging leg raise. So you're getting a lot more bang for your buck from a core standpoint and just more stacked, and it just benefits overall. You're getting a lot more out of less weight as well. And today's episode is gonna kind of elaborate a little bit more on that and give you guys even more tools you could start adding in for your pull-ups and your dips. So like I mentioned, a lot of people, they use a lot of strategies to just get the weight from point A to point B, which I definitely understand. But what if I told you that you could also get just as many benefits with a little bit less weight in more of a stacked position? So you could actually position the weighted dip belt in a way that I'll show you in the video. So stay tuned and let's get into it. So as you can see in the clip right here, the weight belt is forward, which is actually pushing my center of mass more forward as well. So this gives me a natural interior pelvic tilt. So you have a lot of these lifters who will have the dip belt like this. They'll cross their legs, arch their back, flare their rib cage, and they'll hyperextend their neck. And this will definitely help them get the weight from point A to point B. There's no question about that. But you have to think about, what are the consequences? Why do we want to lock ourselves in those positions when we could simply take the weight belt and put it backwards? This will actually put us in more of a quote-unquote posterior pelvic tilt, which should get us a bit back to neutral, and you just do it that way. Not to mention that I made a video a couple months ago talking about why when you do your pull-ups, when you do your dips, you should have your knees in front of you. This will recruit the abs more and you're less likely to hyperextend. So as you can see from the side view, this is what it looks like. Super simple. I can feel my abs firing and it's just great alignment overall. I feel way more stacked this way. Now if we're talking about pull-ups, I know I mentioned a couple months ago regarding having knees above the hips if you have a doorway pull-up, or you could just do straight legs if you have a higher pull-up bar. But once again, this could also be applied to take it even further. You could just put the dip belt in back of you, so get you in a more tucked position, and you're going to be less hyperextended when you do it that way. So that means less spinal erectors, you get more out of less weight, and all that good stuff. Probably going to wake up with less low back soreness as well. So here's the back view, as you can see. And this feels great. You don't have to, you could get a lot more out of less weight when you do this fashion as well. I know I've been getting a lot of benefits, but yeah.
All right, so there you guys have it. Hope you got some value out of today's episode. I know this video may not apply to everybody, and I definitely understand. But this is just personally how I've been doing my weighted pull-ups along with my weighted dips. So let me know if you guys learned anything, if you got any value out of today's episode. Let me know in the comment section below, and see you guys next time.